Guys, Fortnite just released a ton of new info, and one of the brand new things is a mistake that led to players getting awarded this. Now guys, before we jump into it, if you are hoping for the next day off of school, you guys know what to do. Leave a thumbs up on the video before it starts. But yes guys, we have got so much to talk about in today's video. Of course, we're going to be covering that mistake, but we're also going to be going over an unreleased weapon that we were able to get in-game, a glitch, skin-related stuff, and a ton more. Now as for the challenge, with the comments on last video, the skin was Raven. So with that being said, I left hearts on a bunch of the comments that got it right, and this time around, let's do this skin right here. I just randomly chose it, so comment down below if you know the name, and I will heart a bunch of the comments that get it right. Also, be sure to let me know down below if you use code SIRS in the item shop, and I will leave hearts on a bunch of those as well. Oh, and also, I gotta say, over 80% of the people that watch these videos are not subscribed. That means they're missing out, so be sure to subscribe and turn on notifications. But without further ado, let's go ahead and jump on into it. So yes guys, hopping on into it, as I said earlier in the video, we have got a variety of different stuff to talk about. The stuff about the mistake that Fortnite made is coming up soon, but before that we have some other fun things to go over, like a funny glitch in the game. So for this, let's hop into a solo match and check it out. So yes guys, here we are on the Battle Royale map. This is my first game on, so hopefully we don't run into anybody, but for this little glitch specifically, it happens at a certain location, which is Risky Reels, right over here to the left of Colossal Coliseum. So here the battle bus is going, so let's drop down there. Oh man, the OG Risky Reels. This location has been changed so much over the years. That was weird. We got 10,000 XP. That must have been like a random little challenge we haven't completed. But yeah, I'm just gonna go ahead and grab some weapons in case we do run into anybody here. Yeah, let's hop into this little bug. So basically, it's just a funny one. Again, we're starting this video off small, but if you go over to certain spots, like for example, this thing right here, this railing, you can sand tunnel on top of the railing, which again is completely pointless besides it just looking hilarious. But yeah, I'm not even like touching the sand, and for some reason it lets you just, you know, go into the sand tunnel ball completely above the ground, which looks hilarious. I wonder if there are other places you can do this. Okay, so the hay bales are a little bit too high to do it on. What about like this car right here? Can we go on like the back of the car? Oh my gosh, we can. Oh wait, no, it stopped. Why did it stop halfway through? That's so weird. Oh, what about a chest? Imagine if you could sand tunnel through. Oh, it like starts and then stops. No way. I want to see what it looks like to sand tunnel into a chest. That would be crazy. Oh, did we get it? Come on. Oh my gosh, we got it. Oh, that doesn't look funny at all. Sometimes it distorts like the texture of what you're sand tunneling under, but that didn't work. I'm disappointed. All right, but next up guys, we have got an unreleased item to take a look at that can actually be picked up in game. That's right guys, this was like accidentally added into one of the LTMs, and that LTM is the unvaulted mode. So let's go ahead and hop into that and see if we can get this unreleased item. All right, so for this, we kind of just gotta play normally, I guess, and search around for this unreleased item. So I don't know, maybe go over to Pleasant Park or something. I still don't have my normal controller. It's still getting fixed, which is a little annoying, but hey, I can still put up a decent fight, at least I think. All right, we're going to the brick house. This one has a bunch of chests inside of it and a bunch of good loot. We gotta find this unreleased item inside of here. All right, nothing in the downstairs area. Let's see if there's anything inside of the actual chests. I know it can come in, I think, at least green rarity, so that's super helpful. All right, yeah, let's break into the top room and grab this chest as well. Come on, unreleased item. Oh, not yet. Dang it. Unlucky on the first house. Dang, and people are fighting over in the middle of Pleasant Park. I don't like this, guys. Got another chest right here. Come on. No. Jeez. Oh, at least we got the Chug Jug. Wait, did they update the animation for the Chug Jug? Guys, is this recent? I don't remember ever, you know, carrying it, like, under your arm. I always carried it, like, in your hand as a small Chug Jug. Tell me I'm not crazy. Has this been added recently? Or am I just blanking out? I don't know. I'm sure you guys will let me know. What the? There's two guys trying to fight me right now? Oh, this isn't gonna work for you. I got the one guy. Oh, and there's another one. All right, I see you. We got that guy too. Let's go. They can't stop us. Oh my gosh, guys, we found it. The machine pistol, or basically like the upgraded machine pistol. Look at that. The brand new unreleased item that has pretty much never officially been in the game. I think it was accidentally added once before, but take a look at this. That is right, guys. A brand new item inside of Fortnite that was accidentally accidentally released in the unvaulted LTM. Let's see what it looks like when you go ahead and fire it here. Oh my gosh, that is so sick. Yeah, and this thing is like super rare. It took me so long to actually find it. There you go. There you have the stats. Damage 17, which is fairly low, but it shoots really fast. Has a decent magazine size and reload time. But yeah, it is a very tough item to find. Now guys, another bit of new info, which is super cool, points towards a brand new skin coming into the game soon within the next update, or it's possible this could be encrypted, but either way, this clue was found inside of the promotional image for the, however you pronounce this skin. I don't know. But yeah, this loading screen is super cool. You've got the brand new skin, which is obviously the counterpart to Menace. You've got the glider, the pickaxe, and then the Black Knight skins on the bottom, which is pretty interesting. However, there is a secret in the background of this image. So if you zoom in on the right side, you can see what appears to be an armored variant of Peely doing the thumbs down emote. That's right, guys. Yeah, it seems like Peely is wearing some sort of gladiator type bronze goldish armor, similar to the armor Menace has. Now guys, if we hop back into game here for a second, that skin may seem a little bit familiar to you. And the reason for that is because it can kind of already be seen inside of Colossal Coliseum, which is obviously this location right here. Now, what I am talking about specifically is these Peely statues. That's right, guys. These Peely statues look pretty much exactly like what we see in that image. He's got what seems to be the same armor, this little band around his head. Obviously, you know, you just replace it with some colors, and you've got pretty much what we saw in that teaser image. He's even doing the thumbs down emote, which is exactly what we saw. So with that being said, it seems this is a little teaser about that skin coming into the game soon, whether in the next update, update 15.50, or some other time this season. Now also, the thumbs down emote is already in the files, so it makes sense that it comes out again alongside this skin to again represent those statues that are seen inside the Colosseum. Now after that, guys, let's talk about a mistake that Fortnite seemingly made, and that led to them giving out this stuff right here. So yeah, if you logged in recently, you may or may not have gotten a notification that looks exactly like this. And take a look at the message it says right here. This is for you. It says they're giving these to anyone that purchased a random loot llama in Fortnite's Save the World game mode before they were discontinued. While this settlement was for US players only, we have decided to make this benefit available to players globally. And then they tell you that they hope you enjoy them. Now again, guys, I'm not 100% sure why they are doing this, but I think it has to do with the randomness of the loot llamas in Fortnite Save the World mode before. Because similarly, they did the same thing for Rocket League, but instead of loot llamas, it had to do with the crate system that was available way back when. They awarded players 1,000 of the credits, which are basically the same type of thing, and I'm pretty sure a similar message was displayed. So I think something must have happened, you know, in the US, and that led to Epic Games giving these out, which is super cool. Now, unfortunately, if you didn't buy a loot llama way back when, I mean, that was a long time ago that they were even available, I want to say even a year ago, you won't be able to get this, unfortunately, but if you did, here you go. And also, remember to use code SIRS in the item shop, hashtag Epic Partner, it helps out the channel a bunch. But keeping it going here, guys, we have got a bunch more to talk about in this video. Like, for example, Fortnite just announced something brand new, and that is a new unvaulted item, like, in the normal modes. As you guys know, in the previous update, they had added the Flint Knock pistol back into the game, which was super fun. I love that item a lot, but they actually just vaulted that item. But don't worry, guys, they replaced it with a brand new one, or like a brand new unvaulted item. Now that item is the hand cannon. Not the craziest of items, but it's definitely interesting to have back. It won't like mess anything up balance wise, at least as far as I'm concerned. But yeah, that should come in like the usual rarities of Epic and I think Legendary. I don't think it comes in blue rarity, but I could be wrong. So yeah, that's a ton of fun. However, what I find most interesting about that announcement is that it seems like they're going to continue to swap in vaulted items over the course of the rest of Season 5. I mean, they have already added two in the span of like, what, a week? And considering that the unvaulted LTM was just released and there are so many vaulted items that could come back, it would make a ton of sense. So not confirmed, but very likely. And then keeping it going here, guys, let's talk about some skin-related info, and this has to do with the March Crew Pack. So we won't spend too much time on it, but basically, we got the official announcement of the Lombro February Crew Pack, and it's pretty interesting. I'm not 100% sure what I think about it, and you guys should let me know your thoughts down below in the comments. I'm just curious to see what you guys have to say. But hey, it's a llama-themed one, so we gotta love it, right? It seems to be based off of like the llama corn type things. The pickaxe is like this balloon type variant of the, I forget the something smash pickaxe.
tracks.
So that looks pretty fun. I'm hoping it makes like a cool sound or something. And then on top of that, you get a pretty cool looking back bling called the Up North back bling. Looks like it'll be hard to put together with other skin combos, but hey, gotta like it. But actually, what is one of the coolest things is the wrap you get, because it is a reactive wrap. As you can see here, thanks to iFireMonkey, it has an animation that changes every time you fire it. And when you're not firing a weapon, it more slowly changes colors. Now, one question that comes up is whether or not this has a separate style, because as you may remember, two of the three crew packs that have already released had separate styles. You had Galaxia with the two, and then most recently V with the pink and blue styles, which honestly looks super cool. I love the icy style for V. Definitely one of the best skins out there, I'm gonna say that. So for this one, you know, maybe they changed some colors around. It'd be cool to see the dark variant, because that pickaxe does have a dark variant. So I'm putting a guess out now. Let's see if it's right. And also, guys, there's rumors that this will be available on the 28th. I'm not 100% sure if that is a fact quite yet, but I still thought I'd throw it out there just in case. So yeah, guys, that's gonna be it for this video. Be sure to check out my brand new channel. It is the top link in the description. I just posted a new myth-busting type video of what happens when a boss enters the 0 point, so be sure to check that out. But also check out some of my previous videos on the screen right now, and don't forget to subscribe for brand new videos coming up in the near future. Got lots of awesome stuff planned. But again, hope you guys enjoyed today's video, and I'll see you in the next one.